and welcome to another knife review here on my channel. Today I have the Osabo Pradel knife here with me, which I have most of the time in this great leather pouch, which is made by Grasis Leather Bushcrafts, Leder Bushcraft. He's a German like I am, so you will notice it. English is not my native language. So in 1867, Etienne Pradel produced this knife, or this pattern of knife, and its concept was a farmer and fisherman's knife, which was very, very simple build. The today's version here from Osabo, or Le Sabo, this version has XC75, which is a high carbon steel, and with handle scales made of horn. Look at that. Okay, come on, let's go tabletop. Well, the Pradel tabletop version is better, I believe. It's not meant to be a fine gentleman's pocket knife, but in today's speaking, in today's languages, people would say this is a gentleman's pocket knife, just because of the horn and that the people not get scary by a one hand opening or flipping knife, you know. Today's people, they're very scary when it comes to knives, I can tell you from personal experience. Well, there's no blade play. It's a two-hand opening knife, no lock. It's just a slip joint, which is not the modern version of a pocket knife, but it still works. And if you don't take too much pressure on the spine, it will not close on you. If you use it like you have to use a knife, like, yeah, cutting, yeah, look how sharp it is. And I sharpened it just one time after weeks now I've got it. And you saw my food prep video before the real video started. I used the same video material for my German review on this knife. This is meant to be, yeah, like I said, a farmer's knife or a fisherman's knife. In today's purpose, you would say it's an all-round purpose knife when it comes to food prep, finer gentleman's use. And you see it's a high carbon steel blade, XC75, yeah, XC75, which is like a 1075 high carbon, but the French version is XC75, which will find use in most of German gentleman pockets knives in Solingen. We have five pins. Look at it, the build quality. There's no gaps. Yeah, everything is nice and flush. We have a special thing when you notice the spine on the presentation side where it stands, Pradel Le Sabo. When I saw this the first time, I thought it's a fault. Yeah, when they made the spine, the machine or the craftsman made a mistake and made this round here on this side, and on this side it is sharp, yeah, but it is not. It's more like a sign of the company Le Sabot, And well, you hear the church bell ringing. If you're interested, I'll show you where I am now. Look at that. This is where I am. There's a cabin. This is my cabin. Yeah, I'm filming with a tripod selfie stick. I have no choice. Okay, so desktop again. Let's come to the data. Datas. Grams. The wooden version weighs about 66 grams, I guess. And the blade is 9 centimeters from tip to the sharpening choil, and and 9.6 centimeters to the bolster. This is an stainless bolster. With the bolster, the handle has 11.3 centimeters, and we have 1.2 centimeters of thickness of the handle. And 3 millimeters blade thickness. So this knife is very elegant for my taste. It's the horn is very high polished, very smooth. You cannot feel the pins on both sides. It's rounded here. When you notice the patina, which came when I made something to eat, and I used mustard, sweet mustard, for eating Bavarian white sausage. I spread it all around here and let it laying there for maybe half an hour, and forced this patina, which will prevent for rusting. But the bolster seem to be has some color on it now. You can see the pin of the bolster, which is the the pin from the axis. Not a high end knife. I think it costs 39. I bought it at a German online store, Brandner's Homestyle. Put here the name of the website and make a link in the description box. This is not a sponsored video. I bought this knife, and but it's from my perspective highly recommended, especially in Germany, or when you live in a land or a country where you're not allowed to have an one-hand opening knife which locks or not locks, or a one-hand opening knife. You're allowed only have knives which are opening by two hands and closing by two hands, not locking. And you see this here, when I take some pressure on the spine, when it's closed, you have little play, so you don't have to worry about the sharpness of your knife when you are a big fan of Lagiol knives. So it will not get damaged, the blade, when you close it on the 90 degree stop like that. Boom, there you are. This is a, like I said, from my perspective, a highly recommended knife. I carried it like that in my leather pouch from Krasis Bushcraft, which I love, which I carry on my belt, or in my front pocket or back pocket, like whatever I want. And this is, as I said, highly recommended. Even Kasi's bushcraft leather style sheath. Nice EDC knife. And with this in combination and my Phoenix flashlight, which is my EDC flashlight, you see, brings light even in the day. So that's my review on the Le Sabot Pradel knife. Thanks for watching. Hope you have a great day and take care. Bye bye.